Hey, it's Allison Bales, and it is snowing out here in Atlanta for the second time in 11 days, and that gives us a great opportunity because you see the snow is piling up on the roof there, and that means that not today, but in a day or two, we'll be able to walk around the neighborhood and see what these roofs look like with the heat coming through the attics of some of the houses. Not so much for mine, though, although we have some interesting stuff on the back of my roof as well. The first thing to point out here when you're trying to read the roof is that you have to pay attention to what other things might be causing the snow on the roof to melt. Here, you see my roof a couple days after the snow, and mostly it is clear, except for over here you see a little bit of snow, but that's because it's shady. This is the south side of the roof. Let's take a look at the north side now. Here is the north side of my house now, and notice there is a lot more snow on this side than on the front side facing south. This is facing north, which means the sun, although it does hit it, it's coming in at an angle that makes it hard for that snow to absorb much heat, and so the snow stays there. What you do see there, though, is some interesting melting patterns, and that's from heat inside the house. I'll come back and talk about that towards the end of the video. Knowing that it's the north side of the house that's the most interesting part for heat loss from the house, I walked around the neighborhood and took pictures of some of the north-facing roofs around my house. Here's one. Two interesting things here. On the left side, notice there's a lot of snow on that roof. What's going on there? Well, that's a carport underneath, so it's cold underneath. There's not heat rising up to melt the snow on the roof. But over the living space in the middle of the house, notice there's a lot of melted snow, especially in the middle. The heat loss that you see here is due to two things. First, there's probably not enough insulation in this attic. And second, there's a lot of air leakage from the house, most likely. There's warm air rising into the attic that gets up to the underside of the roof deck, and heat goes through the roof deck, melts snow on the roof. That's why you see this pattern. Here's another one from the neighborhood, and notice this one has some very interesting stuff going on. It's a steeper roof, and that means it gets less sun coming in at an angle that's likely to melt it, so there should be more. But it's got those four dormers. Roofs with dormers often are very hard to seal up properly. So the dormers indicate that there's conditioned space up there, and so there's going to be some vaulted ceilings, there's going to be some attic knee walls. Those spaces typically are very bad at controlling heat flow. Here's one with some of the same problems that we saw in the other photos. It's got the garage on the left with lots of snow on it. There's no heat in the garage, so that snow is staying there. But over the main house, we've got a interesting snow melt pattern, and the one thing that really stands out here more than the others is that stripy pattern. Take a look at the lines going up and down the roof. What that tells us is that wood is a better insulator than air. We have an attic here that is insulated on the attic floor, almost certainly, and up at the roof line we have the rafters with air between them. So wood rafters with air between them. Air is not as good an insulator as wood. So the snow sitting on top of where the rafters are beneath the roof deck is staying there longer than the snow between the rafters. This house has the same pattern on the left side as some of the others. You see all that snow there on the left side, and that is because that's a carport. There's no heat rising up, except there's that one bare spot, which makes me wonder what's in there. It might be in the attic, maybe in the carport, maybe a water heater. But when you look at the main part of the house here, what I see is a cry for help. This house needs a lot of attention because there is almost certainly little or no insulation in that attic and probably some significant air leakage. So a lot of heat loss from the house into the attic. They're paying for that. And that's what you see there with all the melted snow. There's nothing left except around the perimeter, and that's the overhangs over the cold air. So that's why that snow's not melting. Here's a house that I actually know a lot about because this is the house that my wife grew up in. And back in 2009, I did a lot of work on this house. I started with a full assessment. I spent a lot of time in the crawl space and the basement and the attic. In the attic, I found a lot of very interesting things. I found unsealed wiring penetrations for this house built in 1962. I found can lights galore that were not airtight. And the most interesting thing I found up there was this air leakage site right here. This is a refrigerator vent. Of course, you have to have a refrigerator vent, right? Heat comes off the back of the fridge, so you vent it to the attic. No, wrong. This is a very bad idea, and you can tell from all the dirt in that yellow insulation, or what used to be yellow insulation, that a lot of air moved through that hole over the couple of decades that that was there. I sealed it up. I got more insulation in the attic. I sealed up as many of the other air leakage sites as I could, and that house performs a lot better now, as you can see from all the snow on that roof. Now, let's go back to what I said at the very beginning of the video. I showed the picture of the back of my house with a bunch of snow on it, but there were also some melted spots. Let's take a look at the reasons why those spots didn't have snow. Let's look at the place labeled number one first, and that is a result of the new roof that we got put on last year. We had our shingles replaced. At the time we had that done, I took advantage of that work to have some penetrations removed from our roof. The spot that you see right here is where the old furnace flue was. We went all electric in 2019. I had the furnace flue removed when we had the roof replaced, but I have not gone back in and re-insulated that spot, as you can see in this photo. The second place is where the two bath fans penetrate the roof. Those were the terminations for the two bath fans. We have metal duct in there. Metal is highly conductive for heat flow. Heat is flowing through those metal ducts and getting up to the roof deck and melting some of that snow. The third one you see here is also a result of our roofing work that we had done. At the bottom edge of the roof, I had a penetration removed here for a plumbing stack. And you can see in this photo that when they put the deck back on, they put it right over a fairly uninsulated spot. So I need to get in there and do some work on that as well. Okay, so there you have it. That's a lot of information about how to look at a roof after a snowstorm and see what might be going on with what's happening in the attic of the house or underneath the roof that's causing the snow to melt up there. So in my case, I've got spray foam on the roof deck, but it doesn't really matter. You have to have good insulation and air sealing either on the attic floor or at the roof deck to make sure that you limit the amount of heat loss. So in all the other stuff that I talked about, I mentioned two sources of heat loss from the house that causes snow to melt on the roof. But there was a third one that I did not mention, and that is if you have ductwork in the attic, if you have duct leakage, if you have poorly insulated ducts, heat comes off of those in the wintertime as well, can make its way to the roof deck and melt that snow too. Well, that's it. That's your lesson for the day on how to read the roof after a snowstorm to see what your snow melt pattern is telling you about heat loss from your house and how that affects your energy bills and also comfort and durability of the house and things like that. If you learned something from this video, please hit the like button, subscribe to our channel. If you like this kind of stuff, we do lots of building science stuff. We cover all kinds of topics in building science.